Good morning and assalamu alaikum students. Beta, can you hear me, girls and boys? Class 9, can you hear me? Class 9, can you hear me, beta? Kindly inform me so that I can start my lecture. Nobody is replying me. What are you doing, class? Are you there? Class 9, can you hear me? Class 9, can you hear me, beta? I'm not getting your replies. Okay, Ibtisam. Okay, let's start our lecture. Okay, before I start my lecture, I just want to ask you one thing, that in my previous lectures, previous week, repeatedly in every lecture, in every class, I have informed you again and again that you are supposed to submit your English language journals, not English literature journals. Again and again in each class, I have informed you that you have to submit your English language journals, not literature journals. But in spite of this, most of the students have sent their literature journals as well, and we have returned them to your parents. Whoever has come to submit the journal from your home, we have returned your literature journals, and you were supposed to submit your English language journals only. What does it mean? It means that you don't listen to me at all. You just log in the class and just you go to sleep. It means that you people are not paying attention to the teacher, what she is telling you, what she is asking you. If you people have listened my instructions, listened to me carefully, the students who have really listened to me, they have sent me English language journals. But remaining students who were non-serious, who just joined the class, written their attendance, and then they don't care at all what the teacher is telling them, they have sent English literature journals because they have not listened my instructions. And one more thing is Dua Kashif. Dua Kashif, are you there? Are you present in class? Okay, she is not here. Anyways, let's start today's lecture. Obviously, today is our English literature journal, literature lecture, because our previous week was English language week. And now your English language journals are with me for the checking. And that is why today is your English literature lecture. And this ongoing week will be your English literature week. And we are going to have lecture number 37. And date is 14th of September 2020. And today we are going to have lecture number 37. Okay. A new lesson we are going to start today. We are going to start a new lesson, lesson number 11. And page number is 64. And name of the lesson is Rain in Summer. And it's a poem which is written by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. Okay, those who are having their books with them, they can open page number 64, lesson number 11. And it's a poem, Rain in Summer, which is written by Henry Longfellow. Okay, if we talk about the introduction of Henry Longfellow, who has written the poem, children? Who will give me the answer? The poem, children, is written by who? Hurry up, I'm waiting for your answers. Who has written the poem, children? Who is the poet of that poem? Class 9, are you listening me? Nobody is replying me at all. Yes, Adil, very good. This poem, Children, is written by Henry Longfellow. And if we talk about the introduction of Henry Longfellow, and if you open your book, In Rain in Summer, the introduction or the reference of the poet is not given. But you have to learn the introduction of the poet, the reference of the poet from the poem Children. Why? Because the writer or the poet of those both poems is same Henry Longfellow. Henry Longfellow has written the poem Children, and Rain in Summer poem is also written by Henry Longfellow. Okay, so once again, I'm telling you that if you open page number 64 of your book, there is no introduction of the poet in that poem. But the Children is written by Henry Longfellow. So in that poem, the introduction of the poet is mentioned. The introduction of Henry Longfellow is mentioned. So you can learn the introduction of the poet from the poem Children. Okay, so a brief introduction about the poet Henry Longfellow. This lovely poem about rain in summer is written by the American poet Henry Longfellow. He was born in 1807 and died in 1882. He was a professor at the Harvard University, which is considered to be one of the best American universities. He was very interested in the culture of other countries and had traveled widely. His poems deal with not only the American scene, but also much of what he saw during his travels. Okay, so what we have learned about the introduction of the poet is that Henry Longfellow was the American poet. He was born in 1807 and died in 1882. He was a professor at the Harvard University, which is considered to be one of the best American universities. He was very much interested in the culture of other countries, but not only in the culture of America, but the culture of other countries as well. So for this purpose, he traveled widely throughout the world. Only whatever he has observed during his journey, during his traveling, he noted down everything and he composed the poetry. Okay, in his poetry, in his poems, he has mentioned each and everything about the culture of America, not only America, but the culture of other countries as well. Okay. This is about the introduction of Henry Longfellow. Now, what is the important thing that you are supposed to learn in the introduction of the poet is, first of all, you have to learn that he was the American poet. Second thing, his date of birth. He was born in 1807 and he was died in 1882. Okay, what was his profession? He was a professor at the Harvard University. Beta, please, Harvard University ke spellings bahut acche se yaad karein. Most of the students write H-A-R-W-A-R-D. It's absolutely wrong. The right spellings of Harvard University are H-A-R-V-A-R-D. Okay? Harvard University, which is considered to be the one of the best American universities, and he was interested in the culture of other countries. It means he was not only interested in the culture of America, but also the culture of other countries as well inspired him or impressed him. That is why he traveled widely throughout the world, and whatever he has observed during his travels, he has composed the poetry, including the culture of America and other parts of the world as well. I hope the introduction of poet is very much clear to all of you. Let's move towards the poetry now. Okay, this poem is included. This poem included three stanzas altogether, but in today's lecture, I have included two stanzas only. I will explain you two stanzas in today's class and remaining one stanza in tomorrow's class. What is the purpose of splitting these stanzas? The basic purpose of splitting these stanzas is to make you clear each and every explanation, the meaning of difficult words and their explanation to make you clear. Why? Because in your exams or in your test, a question is given to you, any two lines can be taken from any poetry, any poem, and you will be supposed to write the explanation of the given lines. Either it can be given to you in the form of words, question answers, RTC, or blanks, or MCQs. So, whatever I explain you in the explanation of these tensas, kindly listen to me very, very carefully and make habit of notes taking. Notes taking habit is very healthy habit. You have to practice this habit. You have to make this habit to whatever teacher is telling you. Either you are taking an online class or a physical class, you should develop this habit of notes taking. It's a very healthy habit, and these notes are very, very helpful for you in your papers, in your exams, in your tests. Okay, there are many important things which teacher tell you during the lecture. Maybe it's not mentioned in the book. बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि teacher आपको other than which is written in the books, उसके अलावा भी बहुत सी information आपको देती हैं teachers. So kindly develop this habit of making your notes. And these the note taking habit is very healthy habit. It will be very helpful to produce a good result. Okay, so let's start reading first tensa. How beautiful is the rain after the dust and heat, in the broad and fiery street, in the narrow lane, how beautiful is the rain. Okay, so first of all, I will give you the meanings of difficult words. Let's see the meanings of difficult words first. Fiery. Fiery means hot like fire. Fiery means hot like fire or acting like fire. Means hot like fire. Aag ki tarah garam. Lane means street, galiyan. Okay, so let's move back. Okay, as the name of the poem is Rain in Summer, तो आप लोगों को खुद ब खुद आपके mind में आ रहा होगा कि this is something about rain in summer. We all know that as we are Karachiites and we all experience a very hot weather in Karachi. हमें सबको पता है कि अगर हम कराची की बात करें तो कराची में बहुत ज्यादा बारिश नहीं होती है. एक स्पेसिफिक पीरियड होता है if we compare पंजाब और नॉर्दर्न एरियाज विद कराची. So we will experience this thing that in Karachi it doesn't rain often. Okay, अक्सर औकात यहाँ पे बारिश नहीं होती है and weather remains very hot and humid. जैसे हम लोग अगर आजकल की बात करें तो the weather is very hot. It's very hot nowadays and humidity is at its peak. Humid भी बहुत हो रहा है weather. तो in this weather, if the rain showers, अल्लाह ताला अगर बारिश बरसा देता है, तो obviously everything becomes so beautiful and everything becomes so clear and pleasant for us. Agar aap apna personal mood ki hi baat kare to acha mausam dekhkar aur ek khoobsurat barish dekhkar hamare mood bhi khud ba khud bahut acche aur pleasant ho jate hain. So this is what the writer is telling us, how beautiful is the rain after the dust and heat. This is the scenario the writer is telling us. The scenario is like this, it's too hot and humid. The dust is everywhere. The environment is full of dust. The environment is full of heat, and it's very hot everywhere in the broad and fiery street. Now, the writer is saying it's too hot like a fire. That is why the writer has used the simile fiery. What does simile mean? Simile means when we compare one thing with another thing. Okay. So fiery means hot like fire. The writer is saying that the atmosphere, the environment is full of dust and heat, and streets and lanes are full of fiery heat. Yani ki galiyan, mohalle, sadke, each and everything is as hot as fire. Yani ki itni garmi hai ki usko writer aag se mushabiyat de raha hai, aag se compare kar raha hai ki it's too hot like a fire. as you people are staying at home right now, maybe you don't experience this thing ki abhi kitni garmi ho rahi hai. Nowadays, Karachi is being too hot and humid. So we can compare this weather with as hot as a fire. Yani ki hum is garmi ko aag se mushabiyat de sakte hain. That is what the writer is telling us. The writer is giving us a scenario. What is the scenario? The writer is saying that before the rain, barish hone se pehle, each and everything is full of dust. The environment is so dusty and it's as hot as a fire. The streets are fiery. The lanes are fiery. Environment is full of heat and dusty. The environment is full of, you can say, dust. The environment is not clear. The atmosphere is so humid that after this dust, after this heat like a fire, when the rain showers, how beautiful this rain seems, how beautiful this rain looks. For example, अगर हम अभी की बात करें तो कितनी शदीद गर्मी पड़ रही है और एकदम से अगर अल्लाह ताला बारिश बरसा दे तो हाउ ब्यूटीफुल दिस रेन विल बी, कितनी खूबसूरत ये बारिश हमें लगेगी. एंड वी विल वार्मली वेलकम दिस रेन, वी विल वार्मली वेलकम दिस रेन. हमें इतनी खूबसूरत लगेगी कि एकदम से आप देखें इस वक्त गली मोहल्ले सड़कें तमाम फुल ऑफ डस्ट है, गर्मी है, बारिश है, सॉरी गर्मी है इतनी ज्यादा कि एज हॉट लाइक अ फायर, एज हॉट एज फायर, इतनी गर्मी है कि हम उसको आग से कंपेयर कर सकते हैं, आग से मुशाबिया दे सकते हैं. सो आफ्टर दिस डस्ट एंड हीट द ब्रॉड एंड फायरी स्ट्रीट इन द नैरो लेन व्हेन अल्लाह शावर्स व्हेन गॉड शावर्स रेन हाउ ब्यूटीफुल इज द रेन, कितनी खूबसूरत लगेगी ये रेन. Everything will become so beautiful, everything will become so pleasant, everything will become so clear, atmosphere will be so clear, pleasant and beautiful. Even our mood will become so you can say pleasant, and we will feel so happy and excited, and we will warmly welcome this rain after heat and dust. ठीक है, द राइटर इज कंपेयरिंग, द राइटर इज बेसिकली यू कैन से डिपिक्टिंग हिज ओन पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस के इतनी गर्मी इतनी हीट के बाद जब बारिश बरसती है तो हर चीज बहुत खूबसूरत हो जाती है, हर चीज बहुत खूबसूरत लगती है. इवन आर पर्सनल मूड ऑल्सो स्विंग इफ यू आर फीलिंग सो यू कैन से sad or angry or upset because of this hot weather, because of this heat. But as soon as the rain showers, everything will be so beautiful. Even our mood will become so happy and excited. We will feel so pleasant. Okay? एकदम से हमारी अपनी तबीयत में भी एक बहुत अच्छा बदलाव आ जाता है मौसम के साथ कि हमें हर चीज बहुत खूबसूरत लगने लग जाती है. यही गर्मी है जिसमें वी अवॉइड टू गो आउट, एंड एज सून एज इट चेंजेस द वेदर चेंजेस वी प्रेफर टू गो आउट एंड एंजॉय द वेदर. हम लोग प्रेफर करेंगे कि हम लोग कहीं बाहर जाएं, एंजॉय करें, कुछ खाएं, कुछ अच्छा बनाएं. ओके, सो दिस इज द सिनेरियो. द पर्सन द पोएट इज पर्सनली डिपिक्टिंग हिज पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस कि जब तमाम चीजें गर्मी से भरी हुई है, डस्ट है, हीट है, तो एकदम से उसके बाद जब बारिश बरसती है तो मौसम कैसे बदल जाता है और सीन कैसे चेंज हो जाता है, हर चीज कैसे खूबसूरत और प्लेजेंट लगने लगती है. ओके, दिस इज अबाउट रेन इन समर. दिस इज द बेसिक टाइटल ऑफ द पोम रेन इन समर. यू कैन गेट एन आइडिया फ्रॉम द टाइटल ऑफ द पोम रेन इन समर कि रेन इन समर गर्मी की बारिश कितनी खूबसूरत लगती है. एवरीबडी वेलकम्स वार्मली द रेन इन समर. गर्मी की जो बारिश होती है हर इंसान उसका इस्तकबाल बहुत गर्मजोशी के साथ करता है क्योंकि ऑब्वियसली हर इंसान बहुत उकताया हुआ होता है गर्मी से, हीट से, डस्ट से. सो व्हेन द रेन शावर्स तो एवरीथिंग बिकम्स सो ब्यूटीफुल एंड प्लेजेंट. This is about the explanation of first stanza. Is there any confusion? if you want to ask something, hurry up. Any question or any confusion that you want to ask, hurry up, then I'm going to start the next explanation of the next tense up. Anybody? Okay, Adil, except Adil, anybody else? Are you listening me or not? Okay, if the Sam, no question. Okay, so I think we should move forward now. Who will give me the meaning of fiery? What does fiery mean? Hurry up. What does fiery mean? Yes, very good. Too hot. Hot like fire. Very good, Nida. Hot like fire. Adil, very good. Okay, so we are moving forward now. Okay, for your convenience, for your ease, even I have written explanation of the stanza as well. ये पढ़ने के बाद आप लोगों को ये और भी ज्यादा इजीली क्लियर हो जाएगा. लेट्स स्टार्ट रीडिंग द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ फर्स्ट स्टैंजा. मैंने आपको एक्सप्लेन कर दिया है, आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू फर्स्ट स्टैंजा, बट उसी के साथ साथ आई हैव रिटन द एक्सप्लेनेशन एज वेल. हेनरी लॉन्गफेलो, अ फेमस अमेरिकन पोइट, इन दिस स्टैंजा बिगिंस बाय डिटेलिंग एंड डिपिक्टिंग द पिक्चर ऑफ रेनी सीजन, overjoyed by the shower in very hot days. How the rain reduces the thirst of a dry and very hot street and relieves him from the heat and dust if the summer. In the summer, it's in. He says that rain has washed off dust from the narrow and wide streets of the city. The street depicted as if on fire needs the rain to cool its surface. This is the same thing that I have explained you. The streets are as hot as fire and they need the cool showers of rain to become cool, okay, to become pleasant, okay. And this is the rain that reduces the, you can say, reduces the stress of a person, the stressful environment, and relieves the environment, relieves the stress of the environment and relieves the stress of the person as well. This is what I have explained you. Let's, we are moving forward now. Okay, now we are at stanza number 2 and we are going to read stanza number 2. Okay, let's start reading. How it clatters along the rooms like the tramps of hooves. How it gushes and struggles out from the throat of the overflowing spout. First of all, I will give you the meanings of difficult words. Okay, gushes. Gushes means flows with force. बहुत ताकत के साथ बहना. Spout, a pipe fixed on the side of a roof to let rain water come down, जिसको हम उर्दू में परनाला भी कहते हैं. कि अक्सर आप देखिए कि बारिश जब रुक जाती है उसके बावजूद पानी बहता रहता है, इसी स्पाउट से इनको परनाला कहा जाता है. बेसिकली दीज आर द स्पाउट्स विच लेट द रेन वाटर कम डाउन. ये जो परनाले होते हैं, जो स्पाउट होते हैं, ये बारिश के पानी को कहीं जमा नहीं होने देते हैं. Through this spout, rain water comes down. Okay? अच्छा. Tramp of hooves का मतलब है foot, especially of a horse. घोड़े के पाँव. ठीक है? अच्छा. अभी आपने meanings याद रखने हैं. एक word है clatters, जिसका meaning मैं आपको verbally बता रही हूँ. Clatters का मतलब है to create, to make a rattling sound. Okay? Clatter means to create or to produce a rattling sound, means a specific kind of sound. Achha. Now, listen to me very carefully. The writer hame is stanza mein batana kya cha raha hai. How it clatters along the roofs like the tramps of hooves. Achha. Here the writer in these two lines, the writer is making a comparison. Writer किस चीज का comparison कर रहा है कि how it clatters along the roofs. Writer ये कह रहे हैं कि जब बारिश होती है तो हमारे घरों की छत पे जब पड़ती है तो how it produces or creates a rattling sound. हम सबको पता है कि हमारे घरों की छतों पे जब बारिश का पानी पड़ता है तो it creates a specific kind of sound. एक खास किस्म का साउंड, एक नॉइज प्रोड्यूस होता है, एक साउंड क्रिएट होता है. दिस इज कॉल्ड क्लैटर्स. ठीक है, प्लीज गौर से सुनिए. क्लैटर्स मीन्स टू क्रिएट और टू प्रोड्यूस अ रैटलिंग साउंड, अ स्पेसिफिक काइंड ऑफ साउंड. राइटर इज सेइंग के व्हेन द रेन फॉल्स ऑन द रूफ्स, व्हेन the rain falls on the roofs of our houses, it clatters. It means that it creates or it produces a specific kind of sound. And like the tramps of roof. Now, the writer is making a comparison कि मुझे हमारे घरों की छतों पे बारिश पड़ने से एक खास किस्म का sound produce होता है या एक खास किस्म का साउंड क्रिएट होता है. वो साउंड किस साउंड से मिलता जुलता है? ट्रैम्प्स ऑफ हूफ्स, यानी कि घोड़ों के पांव से. अच्छा, आप सबको पता है, आप लोग एक बात नोट करें कि ट्रैम्प्स ऑफ हूफ्स यानी कि अगर आप घोड़ों के फीट देखें, उनके पांव देखें, तो उनके पांव के नीचे एक खास किस्म की, एक आप कह सकते हो लोहे की कोई चीज या स्टील की कोई चीज उनके पांव के साथ फिक्स हुई हुई होती है और जब वो घोड़े चलते हैं तो वो एक खास किस्म का साउंड प्रोड्यूस करते हैं. इवन इफ आवर आईज आर क्लोज्ड बट अ हॉर्स इज पासिंग बाय, वी कैन इजीली आइडेंटिफाई दैट अ हॉर्स इज पासिंग बाय. अगर हमारी आंखें भी बंद हों और एक घोड़ा हमारे पास से गुजरे तो उसके पांव से जो एक खास किस्म का साउंड क्रिएट हो रहा होता है, जो साउंड प्रोड्यूस हो रहा होता है, हम उस साउंड के थ्रू बहुत इजीली आइडेंटिफाई कर लेंगे कि यस इट्स अ हॉर्स, ये एक घोड़ा है. ठीक है, सो दिस इज व्हाट राइटर इज टेलिंग अस दैट कि द व्हेन रेन फॉल्स ऑन द रूफ्स, जो एक खास किस्म का साउंड प्रोड्यूस होता है, अ रैटलिंग साउंड, दैट साउंड इज एज close as to the sound created by the feet of horses. यानी कि आसान लफ्जों में ये कि जब घरों की छतों पर बारिश पड़ती है, बारिश का पानी पड़ता है, तो हमें ऐसे लगता है कि जैसे बहुत से घोड़े एक साथ चलते हुए आ रहे हैं. ठीक है, वो बारिश का जो साउंड है वो बिल्कुल ऐसा साउंड है जैसे घोड़ों के चलने का साउंड होता है, घोड़ों के पांव से जो आवाज आती है. So please keep it in your mind. आपसे एक question पूछा जा सकता है कि in stanza number 2, the writer is comparing with what? The writer is comparing the sound of the rain. So you have to keep it in your mind when the rain clatters along the roofs, when the rain water fall on the roofs, the sound that is produced by the drops of the rain, it is as close as the tramp of hooves. It feels like a lots of horses are running or passing by. उस बारिश के पानी के पड़ने से इस किस्म की आवाज आती है कि जैसे घोड़े चलते हुए आ रहे हैं. So there is a comparison between the sound of the rain and the sound of the tramps of hooves. Okay? The sound created by the hooves of the horses is same as the sound produced by the rain which falls on the roofs. Okay? Achha, kindly give me the answer in a chat box. Are these two lines clear? Ye jo maine aapko bhi comparison bataya hai between the sound of the rain and sound produced by the feet of the horse. Is it clear? Ibtisam and anybody else? Who wants to ask any question? Anything that you want to ask? Because I am going to explain you next two lines then. Okay, so it is clear. Let's move forward. How it gushes how it gushes and struggles out from the throat of the overflowing spout. Gushes का मतलब मैंने आपको क्या बताया? Gushes means flows with force. बहुत ताकत के साथ बहना, बहुत ताकत के साथ बाहर आना. Yes, very good Ibtisam. And spout, a pipe fixed on the side of a roof to let rain water come down. In Urdu, spout means parnala. Okay? So, the writer is saying that the rain water, when the rain water falls on the roofs of the houses, then it gushes out with great power and energy. When the rain water falls on the roof of our houses, it doesn't gather over there. It doesn't stay over there. जब बारिश का पानी हमारी छतों पे पड़ता है तो ये वहां नहीं रुक जाता. Because the spouts are over there. It gushes and struggles out. Means it comes out with great power and energy from the throat of the overflowing spout. कभी कभी तो हमारे जो घरों के परनाले हैं वो overflow कर जाते हैं. यानी कि overflow means उनमें जरूरत से ज्यादा पानी आ जाता है और फिर हम देखते हैं कि जब बारिश stop हो जाती है, when it stops raining, the rain water does not collect or the rain water does not gather or stop on the roofs. It comes out, it struggles out with great power and energy from the throat of the overflowing spout. आप देखिए हमारे यहाँ जैसे we are Karachi Heights and in previous days we have experienced a very heavy rainfall. हम लोगों ने बहुत heavy rainfall को experience किया है और बहुत से accidents भी हुए, बहुत से हादसात भी हुए. Why all this happened? Obviously, you can say lack of planning, lack of management, and there is no storage for the rain water. हमारे पास कोई ऐसी storage नहीं है, हमारे पास कोई ऐसा तरीका कार नहीं है कि जहाँ पर ये बारिश का पानी जमा होता रहे और ये सड़कों पर से, गलियों पर से, roads पर से ये gather होने के बजाय एक खास जगह पर जमा होता चला जाए. This is what we have experienced in previous days. Because of lack of management and lack of planning, we have faced a lot of bad, poor experiences and accidents. Even most of the people have lost their lives as well. So this is what in houses, हमारे घरों पर, इमारतों पर परनाले बनाए जाते हैं कि बारिश की सूरत में या किसी भी सूरत में अगर पानी हमारी छतों पे पड़ रहा है तो it should not gather. It should not be collected at the same place. It should come out through the throat of the spout. परनाले का मकसद ये होता है कि जो भी पानी होता है वो उस परनाले की मदद से बह जाता है, बाहर निकल आता है. Okay? So this is what in first two lines the writer is comparing the sound of the rain with the sound of the feet of the horses. Okay? The particular, the specific sound which is produced by the horses is as same as the sound created by the feet of the horses. And then in last two lines, the writer is saying the rain water doesn't gather or the rain water doesn't collect it at the same place or the roofs. It comes out, it gushes, it comes out with great power and energy from the throat of the overflowing spout or overflowing pipe. Pipe की सूरत में, pipe की शक्ल में ये pipe की मदद से बाहर आ जाता है. Okay? I hope this second stanza is also clear to you. अच्छा. Again, I have written explanation for your convenience के मैंने आपको explain तो कर दिया है, but if you will read the explanation in front of your screens, it will become more easier and it will become more, you can say, feasible for you to understand. So, Longfellow, a popular American poet in this stanza, begins by detailing and depicting the picture of rainy season. He says that the rain is bouncing off roofs and spilling out of guttering. This is what the writer is saying. कि the rain is bouncing off roofs, यानी कि छत पर पानी पड़ रहा है बारिश का, but it is spilling out of guttering, but because with the help of these pipes and spouts, it is coming out, it is spilling out. The spouts are packed with rain rather overflowing, hence the water tries ahead out with force. और यही मैं कह रही हूँ कि बारिश का पानी जोर लगा रहा है, ताकत लगा रहा है, with full energy to come out of these pipes and to come out of the spouts. Okay, I hope this clear. This is also clear to all of you. Kindly tell me in the chat box, is second stanza also clear to all of you? Arya, beta, is second stanza clear? Okay, who is going to tell me the meaning of clatters? Who is going to tell me the meaning of clatters? What does clatter mean? Yes, you can say a rattling sound. RATTLING. A specific kind of sound, a rattling sound. Very good. Okay. What does tramps of hooves mean? What does tramps of hooves mean? Hurry up. What does tramp of hooves mean? बेटा अभी बताया, yes, very good, horse feet or horse shoes, very good इब्तिसाम. Okay, what does gushes mean? What does gushes mean? Gushes का मतलब क्या है? Yes, very good, to flow with force, to come out with force, very good. Okay, now what does spout mean? What does spout mean? Who will tell me the meaning of spout? Very good, Ibtisam. You can say a pipe through which water or rain water comes out. Very good. Okay. Now give me the very good, Adil. Now give me the answer of this question. Why does the writer say that streets are fiery? Why does the writer say that the streets are fiery? What does it mean? Why does the writer use word fiery for the streets and lanes? What is the reason? I hope you must be typing the answers. Hurry up, beta, we are left with 1 minute. What does streets are fiery mean? Yes, basically fiery is comparison as hot as fire. The writer is saying that streets are as hot as fire. It means the streets are too hot, the weather is too hot as fire. Very good, Adil, very good. Okay, so I hope today's lecture is clear to all of you. I don't think so that there is any confusion, because I have given you a lot of explanation regarding these two stanzas. We are left with few minutes, few seconds now. Till my next class, take very good care of yourself. Stay warm, stay safe. Thank you, and Allah Hafiz.